Hello everyone.
Today we are going to start with the next chapter called Behavior of Concrete. In the first chapter we have studied, or in the previous chapter we have studied the concrete and its ingredients with admixtures. As I am Mr. Arvind Kolki, lecturer in Department of Civil Engineering, Jain Polytechnic, Belagavi. As initially we need to understand what is behavior. It is the character it is going to show, or the property it is going to show when the concrete it is being prepared. Concrete when prepared, its behavior must be studied for understanding how and where to be used. Depending upon different parameters of or factors, these phenomena can be studied, like temperature, age, internal and external moisture, and size of the specimen. These are the factors which helps to understand the concrete's behavior when it is being prepared. Relation between water and the cement and its effects on the products which is released by the water and cement mixture and their behavior. As I have explained, some compounds regarding when cement is going to mix with water and it is going to produce some gels. Those gels it has been going to prepare, or it is going to convert itself to hard mass. Those gels or the products, whatever we are going to explain, it is of Bogue's compound. The chemist R.S. Bogue has done an investigation on Portland cement about its chemical composition. Chemical composition in the sense, the cement's chemical composition, like lime, silica, ferrous oxide, aluminum oxide, alkalis and the gypsum which is going to be added for preparation of or manufacture of the cement. And he came up with some chemical compounds on honoring him. The compounds are named after him, that is Bogue's compounds. So whatever the Bogue's compounds we are going to say, those are tricalcium silicate, C3S, that will be in the maximum portion of 30 to 50%, and the chemical name, the formula, it will be of 3CaOSiO2. Similarly, dicalcium silicate, it is C2S, 20 to 45%, and the chemical formula is 2CaOSiO2. Tricalcium aluminates, C3A, 8 to 12%, 3CaOAl2O3. And the last one, tetracalcium aluminoferrate, C4AF, this will be in 6 to 10% of total mass, and the chemical formula will be 4CaOAl2O3 and Fe2O3. So when it comes to hydration of the cement, in the sense, whatever the cement it is going to mix with water, and in turn the cement it is going to produce the products of these, and till it is going to evaporate the heat, that process we say it as hydration of the cement. To stay about the hydration of cement, there must be something we must know is water cement ratio. That is, what is the amount of water must be added to known quantity of the cement is the important factor. To know the value of water cement ratio, first understand about normal consistency, which is very important factor, which helps to know how much the water is required to hydrate the cement. In the sense, whatever the cement is, it is being given on, it is being given for that quantity of cement, it is going to show, or it is going to convert itself to the hardened mass when the water is being added. If we are going to add full quantity of water as the quantity of cement, then the cement paste, it will be in the liquid form. And if we are going to add much lesser water than we will be getting the clumps of the cement particles. So as we have conducted some experiments on those bases, or after some practical problems, we have come to a conclusion that 38% of water with respect to cement quantity, known cement quantity, is permissible for hydration of the cement. So next is gel space ratio. Similar way, whatever the water cement ratio is, as I have discussed in the last chapter, the water cement ratio is the quantity of water to the quantity of cement. The same here, whatever the gel space ratio is, it is the mass of the products which is being converted, or it is being produced when cement is going to react with water. That products, it will be converting itself to gel. Those gels, it is going to occupy whatever the space, or the wherever the space it is being provided, and the rest it will be, or in the sense, whatever the water particles or the water bubbles are present over there, it creates itself as the space or the gap. That ratio we say it as gel space ratio. When the chemicals present in cement which reacts with water, there the products produce in the form of gel. The gel produced will convert to hard matter with age, which shows the strength. When cement water paste is compacted, in the sense we are going to vibrate it, there might be no air voids present in it, but still, due to additional of extra water or due to improper compaction, there might be some chances of getting some air voids. In the sense, if we provide whatever the normal consistency of the water we have discussed, it is 38%. In the sense, we are going to add 38% to hydrate the cement, or the cement it is been converting itself to the products of Bogue's compounds. And if we are going to compact it, compaction in the sense we are going to vibrate it, in the sense whatever the air bubbles are present in the mixture, it is going to come out. If there is no correct compaction, or in the sense we have not given the correct compaction or the vibration, then there might be chances of presence of air voids in the concrete mass. When the hydration takes place, the cement paste converts to gel, and if any air voids present in paste will be occupied by the gels. Even after, if any air voids are present, we calculate the percentage of voids present in the paste, that we say it as gel space ratio. As earlier I have said, this defines the strength of the cement paste. If air bubbles are more, then the strength is going to give less, because the weak portion of the cement or the concrete, it is the air bubbles or air voids or the space present in the concrete. Whenever the pressure is going to act on the concrete blocks, the cracks will start from the air bubbles or the space where the mass it is not present. Next, the hydrated products of Bogue's compounds are calcium silicates, calcium aluminate hydrates, and calcium hydroxides. When the cement clinker or the Bogue's compounds react with water, the gel-like products are released. Those gel-like products are calcium silicate hydrates if C3S and C2S reacts with water, calcium aluminate hydrates if C3A or C4A reacts with water. With these, there is a byproduct being produced और रिलीज्ड दैट इज कैल्शियम हाइड्रोक्साइड COH ट्वाइस। नाउ आई विल बी एक्सप्लेनिंग वट आर ऑल दी CSH, CAH एंड कैल्शियम हाइड्रोक्साइड। CSH इट इज़ द प्रोडक्ट, इट इज़ बीन रिलीज वैन C3S एंड C2S, इन द सेंस द ट्राई कैल्शियम सिलिकेट एंड द डाई कैल्शियम सिलिकेट और एलाइट एंड द बिलाइट, इट इज़ गोइंग टू रिएक्ट विथ वाटर एंड इट प्रोड्यूस द प्रोडक्ट कॉल्ड CSH जेल, एज आई हैव गिवन the equation at the second point. C3A in the sense it is a tricalcium silicate, it is going to react with water and it is going to produce CSH plus n numbers of CaOH twice. As I have said, n in the sense it is number of calcium hydroxide molecules. So if C3S in the sense it is a tricalcium silicate, so here the calcium or the lime products or the lime particles are more, so because on those basis this calcium hydroxide it will be production will be more. If it is C2S then calcium hydroxide products will be less. It is the byproduct when it is being reacted, the by both compounds it is going to react with water. If C3A or C4AF it is going to react with water, it is going to release CaH and the calcium hydroxide. Similar way it is of n numbers only, but here this n number it will be of less numbers. Here in the above equation calcium hydroxide is very reactive with water. Calcium hydroxide it is the hydrated lime which is very reactive with water and itself it is going to convert it as CaO and 2 times H2O, or if it is been reacted with water it is going to show CaO and 2 times H2O and it is going to release the heat. As I have said, when these compounds it is going to react with the water or cement is going to mix with water, it is going to release heat. As I have said, it is the exothermic process. So here the heat it will be released where calcium hydroxide and water it is going to react with, sorry, hydroxide is going to react with water, then only heat will be evaporated. When this calcium oxide, hydrated calcium oxide is more comparing to other chemical products, then this it will be the hydrated calcium oxide, it will be coming out like white colored precipitation or powder paste, we say it as, which we call it as efflorescence. The white colored powder paste or precipitation, whatever it is going to come out, calcium, hydrated calcium oxide, this we say it as efflorescence. If this comes out and it will react with all CSH compound, again it will convert this CSH gel to calcium hydroxide, then again to hydrated calcium oxide. This again weakens the strength of the concrete, or it is going to make the concrete member weak. Next is water requirement for hydration. As I have said, hydration of cement, whatever the amount we have discussed, here I will be explaining. Water is added to cement, prepare paste, paste to gel, and lastly gel to hardened concrete mass. This is done knowing by considering normal consistency value of water to cement volume. Initially, cement particles will react with water about 18% and convert to paste. Then again, same paste again react with water to produce Bogue's compounds. In the sense, the products of books compounds, and water is reduced to required to do so is 15%. And lastly, to remove heat of hydration, the water is required is 5%. The total water required for hydration is 38% for Portland cement only. Don't consider any other types of cements. It might be pozzolanic cements or high strength, high performing concretes. Here we are not going to take 38%. We will be considering only the Portland cement with OPC. Next, in detailed water cement issue. In the sense, as the water is important part in mixture, so usually we need to define the water quantity with some constant thing. That is, in this binding material, constant material is the constant material. So water is measured on the quantity of cement or the binding material. The ratio of water quantity to the cement quantity is called water cement ratio. So it's been said that some law will be explaining what will be the water cement ratio and how it will be used. The laws, it is being made by Abrams, and on his name only here they have created a law saying that Abrams water cement ratio law. The law states that the strength of a concrete mix is inversely related to mass ratio of water to cement. So now the thing is the strength and the water cement ratio. These are all the, both are the important cases. So strength of concrete, it is said that it will be the inversely proportional to the water cement ratio. If water cement ratio is going to increase, then strength of the concrete decreases. You understand this. Next, effect of various water cement ratio on the physical structure of hydrated cement. Physical structure of hydrated cement, in the sense, it might be the internal moisture, temperature, age, and size of specimen. So now, with respect to, I will be explaining the more water cement ratio and less water cement ratio. For internal moisture, if water cement ratio is more, then it will be helping to control heat of hydration in the heavy temperature areas. If it is less water cement ratio, then it will be helping or maintaining the heat of hydration in low temperature areas. Similarly, when it comes to temperature, if water cement ratio is more, it will be helping the concrete member to keep it cool during high temperature areas. When it comes to less, it will be helping in less segregation and thermal problems. Thermal problems, in the sense, it might be the shrinkage or expansion in during low temperature areas. Next is age. If the more water cement ratio, then lifespan of the concrete increases. It might show the thermal cracks. Similarly, less water cement ratio, then lifespan of the concrete increases. It might show the thermal cracks of expansion. In the more, it was shrinkage. It might be the plastic or the drying, depending upon the surrounding area. Next is size of the specimen. Considering all parameters of internal moisture, temperature and age, we are going to consider all these parameters. If more water cement ratio is there, then the size of specimen initially increases, then decreases. But the concrete size, it will be in the same size. It might vary in 1 or 2 mm. Rather than that, it is not going to change much. If it is less water cement ratio, then the size of specimen from first day on, it will be decreasing only. Next, relation of water cement ratio and the strength of concrete. The water cement ratio, as the Abraham's water cement ratio law has been explained, strength is inversely proportional to the water cement ratio. But as in the given diagram, what I am going to explain is, as the given figure near the initial point, the strength is more rather than far from it initial point. In the sense, in the x-axis it has been given water cement ratio, and in y-axis it is compressive strength. So for initial stages, the strength of the concrete is much more rather than it is going far from the y-axis. It is because water cement ratio, if it is in the normal consistency level and it is going till the maximum limit, we have considered it as 0.75 to 0.8. If this is the range, 0.38 to 0.8, if 0.38 is the limit we have used, for that the compressive strength will be high, because whatever the cement is going to react with water and it will be converting the compound products all in the gel or in the hardened mass, and there will be no gaps in between. If the water cement ratio or the water content is high, then what happens to occupy that place of the water, we don't have much quantity of the cement. So what happens, the even after compaction we might get some air bubbles due to the presence of water in those places, and after hydration the products which have been produced by both compounds and the reaction of the water, and those gels or the compounds or the products, it is not going to fit in that places. So what happens is, those place it will be kept empty, in the sense it the space it will be increasing. So if the load it has been acting on that point, then it might show the cracks from that point, and failure of the concrete block it will be starting from there. So I have explained in next point the same thing. This means less water cement ratio leads to gain high compressive strength rather than more water cement ratio. Even good compaction leads to gain high strength for proper water cement ratio, normal consistency of water. Please concentrate on the water cement ratio, the proper water cement ratio, in the sense the normal consistency of the water for the given mass of the cement, as well as the grade you are going to prepare. Thank you. Next, the internal properties of hardened concrete. The internal properties, in the sense how it will be showing itself and how it will be how it is interlocked, you can observe here. As I have shown the two pictures at the left side, above the and below the structure of concrete. Structure of concrete, in the sense there are two types, the macro and the micro structures. Macro structure, it is the structure it has been visualized with bare eyes. When you cast the cube and if you are going to check it from the outside, you feel it is fully smooth surface on all the sides. That we say it as the macro structure. When you are going to cut the concrete and you are going to check it, or else if you are going to take the same sample, if you are going to check it through microscope, that structure, whatever it has been given or displayed in the first figure at the left corner, there I have shown One is macrostructure, which is of left side. It is bare, you are going to see it barely without using any microscope. On the other side, or the opposite side, the right side, there I have shown the microstructure of the concrete. In the sense, if you are going to cut it or if you are going to check it directly with microscope, you feel like the fiber structures and some jelly spaces or the jelly particles, that when you are going to add water or the products which are the box compounds which is going to produces those products as CSH, CAH, whatever it is, the structure from which the from the shown figure concrete internally looks like that. If water cement ratio is more, then we may find many pores or voids, and less water cement ratio than segregation of aggregates. This segregation I will be explaining in further slides. Next, the transition zone. This is the zone where it has been explained is between two aggregates. To explain this, first study the figures which been displayed in the slide. First, we will be going through the right side bottom corners figure. There I have shown the aggregates, hardened cement paste and the transition zone. The transition zone, it is the space in between aggregates, and how this paste and the aggregate is going to interlock each other. The same thing I have explained here. As a space between two aggregates will explain the transition zone. If the aggregate are closely compacted, then there might chance of rubbing and breaking of loosely packed placed, then fails due to weaker bond. In the sense, if the aggregates are placed side by side, then what happens, the load is invariant, then there might be chances of rubbing of aggregates on each other, that will create a problem, saying that it will start showing some cracks from that point. If these coarse aggregate are far away, or the ratio of coarse aggregate to the fine aggregate it is less, then what happens, the coarse aggregate will be far away from each other, then whatever the load it is going to put on the concrete mass or the concrete mortar paste, the hardened cement paste as explained, if it is more, then we are going to get less strength comparing to where the coarse aggregate it is been equally placed. Can understand it. Next, so this will end the second unit or the second chapter. Thank you.